Chapter beginning with the 46th verse. And they came to Jericho. And as Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a great crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind beggar, the son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he cried out all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." And they said to the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up. He is calling you." And throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. And Jesus said, "What do you want me to do for you?" And the blind man said, "Rabbi, let me recover my sight." And Jesus said to him, "Go your way. Your faith has made you well." And immediately he recovered his sight and followed Jesus on his way. Have you ever wondered why Jesus healed so many people? We see in the Gospels that he healed people who were blind. He healed the deaf, those who were crippled and could not walk. He also healed those who were lepers and those who were possessed by demons. Some people would say today that those who were possessed by demons might have suffered from epilepsy. Nevertheless, Jesus healed them. He healed them all, in part because it was what he was sent to do, to reveal God's grace and goodness and glory to us. But there might have been something else going on. Do you ever think that each time Jesus healed someone, that he also might have gotten something out of it? Look at blind Bartimaeus. Imagine what it must have been like in that moment when he stood up and said with great excitement, "I can see. Thank you, Lord, I can see. Praise God." In the aftermath of that grace-filled moment, that miracle, it isn't hard to see Jesus standing there with tears of joy in his eyes. So yes, every time Jesus healed someone, he also got something out of it. And that's the amazing thing that you will always find waiting for you behind each of your deeds of loving kindness. When you help someone, it also helps you. And there's nothing wrong with that. It helps you feel good about yourself and better about the world around you. And that's something that we all need with everything that's going on in the world these days. Good people, let us take a moment to center ourselves in the presence of our God, that we may find that sacred center that will bring us fully and totally into the presence of our Lord. Please join me in the prayer of St. Francis by repeating each phrase after me. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O divine master, grant that I may not seek so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand. To be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, and it is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Jesus.